Hello everyone, I'm going to make a resin geode cake stand again, but first of all I want to show you how I clean the mold. So I have already an acetate sheet on my MDF board, and with a little bit of alcohol I'm cleaning the surface, and I'm also cleaning the silicon rubber barriers. There you can see it, with only a little bit of alcohol. And then I place it on top of my acetate sheet, so no hot glue or whatsoever. I'm only laying it down, cleaning it again, the middle shape with some alcohol. Because also this is a part of the process I wanted to show you. So it's nothing special or difficult. It's only the base is an acetate sheet, and on top you place your silicon barrier rubbers, and that's all. And then your mold is done. I only press it a little bit with my fingers down to the acetate sheet. There you can see it. And then the mold is done, and you can pour in it. Yes, I also got questions how I mix my resin and pigment. So I'm starting with the resin. And the resin of Resin Pro. You first need to add your resin and on top the hardener, because the hardener is thicker. So that's what I'm doing. And you need to weigh this resin. So not on milliliters, but on weight. And I needed 500 grams. So I've added 300 gram of resin and 198 gram of hardener, and that's about 500 gram. And then I'm going to mix it. I speeded this up because it's not interesting to see me mix the resin. So you need to mix this for about 3 to 4 minutes. And what I always do is I scrape the bottom and I scrape the sides, because you need to mix this very well so that you don't have any streaks in it anymore. And I also scrape my stirring stick. There you can see it on the top of my plastic cup. And I must say this resin has not a lot of air bubbles, and it's a medium consistency. I like it. So this is how I mix the resin. So also not that difficult. And also in the description of the resin you can see what the ratio is. And now I'm going to show you how I mix my pigments. And I'm going to show you different ones, the inks, the pigments, but also paste. And I'm starting with the pigment, and what you can hold on the tip of your stirring stick I put in the cup. There you can see it, and I'm using 200 milliliter cups, and I fill it about 60 milliliters, and then slowly I'm starting to mix. And with the powders I always add the powders first, and then on top of that the resin, because if you do it the other way around then the powders will blow up in your face. And you don't want that. Yeah, I'm wearing a mask with also filters for dust and for vapors. I think that's the right word. So these pigments, that's one of my own, is the cotton candy. They mix very well in the resin. So now I'm going to show you that you also can mix two different pigments, color pigments, together. So I'm starting with the white lily. That's also one of my own. So what I can hold on the tip of my stirring stick, I put in a cup. Then I'm adding the golden beach, a little bit, because I want to have a cream color, and I don't have that in my pigment line. And again, on top of it, I'm adding the resin, about 50 milliliters. And again, I'm starting to stir very slowly. And so you can see they mix very well into the resin. But first the pigments, and on top of that the resin. because then you don't get it into your face. And I'm always using full protection, so you can see gloves, but also wristbands, a painter's coat, but also a mask, safety glasses. So the next one I'm going to show you is the white paste I'm using. Again, 50 milliliters. And I, oh no, this is the paste of Just Resin. So if you use this paste, you need to stir it very well in the jar, so that all the chemicals are mixed. And I only add a little bit. There you can see it. You don't need a lot of paste. So with the pastes, you can add the resin first in your cup and then the paste. But with the powders, it's the other way around. Mix it very well. Yeah, I think the color is a little bit too bright, so I'm adding one drop of the white casting craft. So with this white, you can make the color lighter. There you can see it. So you can mix those pastes together. It's all possible. So now it has a lighter shade. And now I'm going to show you the white paste. So again, 50 milliliters. And I'm adding 5 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's enough. Not more. Then it's opaque. And again, stirring it. Yeah, and with the powders, it doesn't matter if you add a little bit too much. But with the paste, if you add too much paste to your resin, then your resin can thicken very fast and it will start to smoke in your cup. So you don't want that. But a little goes a long way, so you don't have to add too much. So now I'm going to show you the ink. Starting with a lighter shade, only 3 drops of alcohol ink. And then I have a very light shade of magenta. And this cup has is almost full. Again, the same. A full cup. I think it's 180 milliliters. And now I want a darker shade, so I'm going to add more drops of alcohol ink. I think it's 5. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 5 drops, so the color will be darker. And my last color will be the Sparkle White, and that's one of my own natural mica pigments. And that pigment, you don't need a lot of that. Only a little bit. There you can see it. Opening the jar. Only a little bit into your cup. And this is an amazing pigment. It just looks like glitter. But it behaves not like a glitter, because if you use glitter, it will sink to the bottom. And this pigment will not do that. Mixing it very well. So what's important is that you mix your resin very well, so that you don't have any streaks in it anymore. And with the mixing of the pigments, the powders first, the resin on top, and with the pastes the other way around. There you saw me add some interference pink, one of my own natural mica pigments that I'm testing. You can make the color lighter. Yeah, hopefully you understand what I mean with mixing my pigments and colors and resin. If you have questions, you can also place a comment below this video. But I mixed my colors and I'm starting with the cotton candy on the outside of my silicone barrier. Because I also got a question if I could make a pink cake stand, so that's what I'm doing. This is such a nice pink shade. Yeah, and if you're interested in my own natural mica pigments, the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. I have some nice discounts, and they are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. Also, the link to her Etsy shop is in the description box, so if you're curious, please check that out. So next to it, I add the cream color. I mixed, I made it with the white lily and the golden beads. I think it's a nice color next to the cotton candy. And I let those colors bleed into each other. I think that will look nice. And also about my Etsy shop, I've added the cake stands that are left that I didn't sell already. So if you're interested, the light blue one is listed there, but also the purple one. And I'm starting with the darker shade of the alcohol ink from the electric magenta. So I'm filling the whole layer with this color. And it will hopefully be a nice, soft looking pink cake stand. Pushing the colors together with my stirring stick. So again, about the mixing, if you have questions, please place a comment in the description box. Below this video, sorry. Because I will answer all your questions. It's so difficult to explain how much pigments I put in my resin. But I always say what you can hold on the tip of your stirring stick, that I will put that in the resin. That's the another shade of pink that I mixed out of the Just Resin rose pink, metallic rose pink, together with a one drop of Casting Craft white, but also a little bit of the Aurora pink, one of my own natural mica pigments that I'm testing, and then you get that nice pink shade. And on top, the Casting Craft white. And then the alcohol ink in the middle to push those colors to the outside. But also to create the transparent center that I want. Again, the rose pink shade in the middle. And the white on top again. Yeah, I'm already experiencing that the paste of Just Resin, the rose pink, is... how do you say that? Not that dense than the pastes I normally use. And I normally use the paste of Lures. Because the white sinks very fast through that color. If you look closely. I'm adding a little bit more of the cotton candy on the outside. And my embossing tool for the air bubbles to remove them. Don't use a torch. There you can see it, a little bit of alcohol ink in the middle that I had left. I always try to use all the resin I have mixed so that I don't have to throw it away. And on top the rose pink. And then a little bit of white. And now I'm using the Sparkle White, that's the color I mixed last to create that transparent center. And also to give it a really nice sparkle in the center. Yeah, I'm liking the soft look of this one, this cake stand. Again the rose pink, but then a really small puddle, a little bit of white. And again the sparkle white. So all the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box. I get a lot of questions where I buy my materials, so please check out the description box. I always put all the links to the websites there, and yeah, then you can see where I buy them. So I'm almost done with this layer, need to let it dry before I can take them out of the mold. So this is 1 hour later, so you can see how they changed. I like the cotton candy. It gave me some really nice effects. There you can see it. And the colors are very soft. I like it. Also the larger one, I have shifted rings. So it gives a lot of depth that way. Yeah, it looks great. I don't know how the backside will look. Yeah, we will find out if it's totally dry and I can take them out of the mold. But I'm very curious how the backside looks. But this side, the front side, I think it's very beautiful. So we are 24 hours later and now I can take them out of the mold. What I didn't show is that I've added a food safe clear top layer in the mold, because I want this cake stand to be totally food safe. So that's what I did. And now I am starting on the removing the silicone barriers, and what you also saw in my other videos, that goes very easy. And minor leakage, so I'm very impressed with this silicone rubber and with the barriers I made. The smaller one. And you can make any shape with the silicone rubber. If you want larger shapes, it's also possible. And you can use them again and again. So that's great. And also the silicone rubber isn't that expensive. Also the link to that is in the description box. And I've also have a comparable silicone rubber for the people that live outside of Europe. It's the same as I'm using, but then from a different company. Because ResinPro doesn't ship outside of Europe. So the first one is already removed from the acetate sheet. Now I'm starting with a middle shape, middle size. I always do that very carefully. Yeah, the top side looks very nice, the front side. Have some nice contrast. So they are removed, and now we can take a closer look. This is the smaller one, yeah, minor leakage. You can take it up very easy, it's very thin. So the front side has already a food safe layer, because Resin Pro also has a food safe resin. That's a new resin. I will also add a food safe layer on the back side, then it's totally food safe. And you can place your cupcakes or sandwiches or chocolates on the cake stand. And that is the back side, very nice with the cotton candy and the nice contrast with the middle, with the center part. I like the large shape. It has shifted rings, so it gives a lot of depth. And that is the backside. Very nice. I also like the cream color on the outside. Yeah, I'm very pleased with this result from the of the front, but also the back. Very nice. So this is right after I took them from my acetate sheet, a close-up. Wanted to show you the effects. Yeah, the next step is to sand the raised edge. I have a small raised edge. There you can see it. And drill the holes. I will put all the links in the right corner of drilling holes and attaching the hardware in the center, so you can check out those videos. There you can see the shifted rings, but also the nice sparkle in the center. Yeah, I like the front side very much. And this is the back side, also very nice. There you can see the cream color I made, the sparkle in the middle, but also the rings that creates that depth that I want, and the nice effects in the cotton candy. Yeah, beautiful. The middle size. Yeah, some nice contrast. Yeah, I'm very pleased with the results from the front and the back. And now we'll show you all the end result. So this is the end result. And the end result of the front side. So how I poured it. And I like it very much. I added a food safe layer on both sides now, and I also painted the edges with a gilding liquid. You can find the link in the description box. But I'm very pleased with this cake stand. It's very soft looking, it sparkles a lot. There you can see the effects, also some transparent parts in it. So I'm very pleased. And this is the close-up of the backside, also with some nice effects, some nice rings in it that give me a great depth. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Don't forget to to give me a thumbs up if you like this video. All the information to the websites you can find in the description box. And also the link to my Instagram, Etsy shop, and Facebook page, my Influencers Amazon store for the USA, but also for the Netherlands. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!